These HEK293 cells were cultured in a tissue culture flask and maintained between 10 and 90% confluency in a humidified 37 degrees centigrade, 10% CO2 incubator. The researcher confirms the correct density of cells using microscopy. Cell culture medium is removed from the cells. Then cells are washed one time with PBS. For a T75 flask, 2 milliliters of TRYP-LE trypsin solution is added to detach cells from the plate. The cells are incubated with the trypsin solution for 2 minutes. After incubation, the researcher verifies under a microscope that the cells are detached and that all clumps are dispersed. Trypsinization is stopped by adding 10 milliliters of assay medium per T75 flask. Cells in assay medium are dispersed by pipetting up and down. The cell suspension is transferred to a conical tube. A hemocytometer is used to quantify the number of cells in solution. Cells are counted in order to determine their concentration for subsequent assays. The cells are pelleted at 500 G for 5 minutes at 18 degrees centigrade. After centrifugation, the supernatant is removed. And the cells are resuspended in assay medium to achieve a final concentration of 1 million cells per milliliter. The cells are then pipetted into a 96-well plate according to the following diagram. Cell-free assay medium was pipetted at 100 microliters per well around the perimeter of the plate as a background control. 90 microliters of cell suspension were added to the remaining wells. 10 microliters of DMSO solution were added to half of the wells as an unstimulated control. And 10 microliters of forskolin solution were added to stimulate the cells in the remaining wells. The plate was then incubated for 4 hours at 37 degrees centigrade and 10% CO2. After incubation, the researcher will add assay reagents to the plate and determine stimulated cell activity.